It was like every god that was over humans, I was questioning that.
Are there downsides to hip-hop addiction?
Downsides, you start to believe that you are God, the king of the world, you're this and you're that, and you invented everything, and you become self-centered and lost in your own vain success. You start believing it, and you should. A part of it, you should believe, because you needed to be competitive, and you need to believe in yourself and know that you're great. It is just like anything else. Too much of anything will kill you.
Lessons, struggles, mass hysteria. People worry about the past, but I'd rather look ahead of ya. I'd rather live it merrier. Specifically, I write rap to look back and reflect on what I'm telling ya. And maybe have a choice. Lately, I'm annoyed. It's like Biggie got shot, and it wasn't for a point. If I carried a Glock racially to fill the void, I wouldn't be a man. I would straight up be a boy, a toy of destruction. This noise is disgusting. I stand for the boys and the girls and the publics. I love it, so I say it's time to look at the past and realize you gotta put the hate behind you, cause it could redefine you. You just gotta grind through. We all got our problems. Who you trying to lie to? Just the other day, I was sitting in my rhyme room, cooking up some documents and writing up some haikus. Then I realized that I had somewhere to drive to. Walked outside and my car was vandalized. Dude, I was so mad. I got in the car, I turned the speakers on, and then I started spitting out bars. And it was right then and there that I was living at large. It was me to beat the street while I'm delivering hard. It's the darkness that shows the light in the nighttime. I like to take that point of view when I write rhymes. Living the life every day, and I like mine. Doing what I love, and I live it for a lifetime. Get up, don't waste your whole life, man. Some odd years, you look back and be like, damn, should've got up, spit a rap on that mic stand. Who would've known what happened after that, right, man? If it never happens, give it your best, because that makes life the best experience. Yes.
This is what it's come to. We at Nathan's. Fast food, trans fat, mother.
Rap-a-life.
I don't use a fork, but when I do, I use a Nathan's fry boiler.